You are waiting for us to move. There is so much more, deeper than I've ever known, known before. When we draw near, I see the mysteries of who you are. Reveal my heart to be renewed until
clear way. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The National Weather Service has been issuing some weather advisories back before the blizzard, and I want to read one of them. The weather advisory says, a winter storm warning for heavy snow means severe winter weather conditions are expected or occurring. Significant amounts of snow are forecast that will make travel dangerous. If you must travel. Keep an extra flashlight, food, and water in your vehicle in case of an emergency. The Bible also issues a traveler's advisory in Psalm 121. When we become new believers, we expected that there would be no problems in our new life. We expected a clear road ahead. We soon experienced one of the storms of life. And so much for our expectations. But you know, Jesus did not pray, Father, take away all their problems. He didn't pray, take them out of the world. He prayed, and I'll quote him, I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, Father, but that you should keep them from the evil one. They are not of the world, just as I am not of the world. Sanctify them by your truth. Your truth, your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, I also have sent them into the world. That's found in John 17, 15 through 18. We Christian believers experience the same travel hazards as all who pass through this troubled world. Eugene Peterson writes in a book called A Long Obedience in the Same Direction. It's about discipleship and it's about the Psalms. He writes these words, we travel the same ground others walk on. We breathe the same air. Drink the same water, shop at the same stores, read the same newspapers, buy the same groceries, are subject to the same distresses, dangers, and pressures. We are buried in the same dust. End quote. But the difference between the Christians and others is this, says Peterson. With every step of our journey, we are confident that God is traveling with us. That God rules our lives. And that God will preserve us. We base our confidence on the reliability of God's word. As Christian travelers, we know the spiritual dangers. We know them by experiencing them and by reading God's word. we read the traveler's advisory that God gives. Psalm 121 mentions several travel hazards, and I'd like to go over them with you. This psalm was a traveler's psalm. It was written and sung for travel. The multitudes of pilgrims traveled to Jerusalem 3 times each year for the great religious celebrations, to go up the hill to worship. They were very conscious of the physical dangers along the way, just like we are today. Travelers in the land of the Bible knew there were dangerous loose rocks on their pathway. This morning I saw one of our deacons with a shovel in his hand. Usually he shovels after the sermon. But he was shoveling before anybody got here to clear the pathway. He wanted the pathway to be free of all danger so that we wouldn't stumble and fall. That's pretty hard to do in Israel, where the pathway is full of these rocks that are like walking on marbles. And everybody was aware that if you step carelessly on a rock, you twist your ankle or maybe plunge down a hill. We too have to watch our step spiritually, or we might break a bone or worse. There are a number of hazards to spiritual travel, this journey we're on to the hills of heaven. The Bible is full of characters who took a bad step. They fell off God's path, and their life plunged into moral ruin. A few come to mind. The first king of Israel, Saul. Maybe Samson, the really strong man, whose weakness was his downfall. Even the wisest man, Solomon, slipped into sin, took a bad step. The second point I want to make is that our great Lord offers us traveler's assistance. He doesn't just give us traveler's advice, an advisory. He also helps. He assists. He doesn't just say, if you must travel, keep an extra flashlight and food and water with you. Instead, he offers real help through his Spirit. And when we do experience an emergency, he's right with us. My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to be moved, the psalm says. He keeps us on the safe path, and he guards our steps. And this assistance is available 24/7. I know some of you have a little button in the overhead of your car. And if you have any trouble, you just push that button, OnStar, and I guess there's some others. And that's available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Well, God helps us all the time. 6 times in this psalm, we're told that the Lord keeps us or preserves us. He's our keeper, our protector, our provider, our help. This may sound a little odd to you, but I delight in thinking of us all as animals in a zoo. Can you get that visual in your head? We're all animals in a zoo, and the Lord is our keeper, the zookeeper, who gives us his constant attention, attending to our needs all the time. Our keeper never dozes. He never slumbers. He never sleeps. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Travelers in Bible times had to worry about the sun. If they were to get too hot, too dehydrated in that merciless desert sun, they could get sunstroke and perish. Travelers did their best to protect themselves from the sun. We need spiritual protection. We need God to shade us from evil, or we will perish. verse 5 and 6. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. How close is your shadow when you're walking outside on a sunny day? How close to you is your shadow? It's right there with you wherever you go. Likewise, the Lord is constantly your shade. He's constantly with you in all your travels. One of us is going to Denver this week. And her husband is going to take her down to North Carolina to get on a plane. And he is confident that the Lord is going to go with her, even though he is not. And not only is the Lord going to go with his wife, but the Lord is going to go with him back to Virginia. That's how close our Lord is. That's how he sticks with us. And we need that protection. Today is Men's Day in Worship. Men have earned a reputation for preferring to go it alone. You can see how well we lined up here in front. We like to do things the way we like to do things, and we like to think that we can do it on our own. And so I'd like to give you men a little traveler's advisory about that approach, and how that worked out for one guy who took that approach. Last Sunday, a good man died from going it alone for 71 days. He was tough. Really tough. He's an explorer in Antarctica. The explorer is Henry Worsley, and he died of exhaustion and dehydration. He was attempting to be the first man to cross the Antarctic unaided, alone. He traveled alone 913 miles in Antarctica. He was a good man, raising money for a charity. He had only 30 miles to go. He'd done over 900 alone. And he only had 30 to go. And he had to call for an airlift to take him to a hospital in Chile. Help came, but it was too late to save his life. He died. Help was available all along. He didn't have to go it alone. But this man perished because he didn't want help until it was too late. The Lord is right there like our shadow with us all the time. He's with us, and we don't have to journey unaided or alone. We can have his help. Sometimes all of us, men and women, slip into depression. The ancients considered exposure to the moon to be as dangerous as exposure to the sun. Did you know that a lunatic is one who is mentally disturbed as a result of moonstroke? That's what the ancients believed. Verse 6 is a very clear understanding, or a very clear statement of that understanding. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon strike you by night. Strong faith in the Lord can keep us mentally strong. We are constantly exposed to the attitudes of this world. The journey gets long, and we don't stop enough to fill our buckets with spiritual refreshment, with living water. Our mind and our spirit are constantly exposed to the outlook of those who have no faith and no hope for the future. The Lord can help us get back on track with a healthy, sound mind. The Lord can refresh our spirit.
Verse 8, the Lord shall preserve your going out and coming in. That is to say, the Lord is with us from the very beginning of our faith journey to the very end. You're going out and you're coming in. Paul Black stood here and gave a testimony today that the Lord was with him on his long journey. And he started his statement, his testimony of healing, saying that he's been on a long journey. God was with him in his going out and his coming in, from the beginning to the end. That prayer that he talked about is our connection with God. That's vital to life, like breathing is to our physical life. We have to stay connected to our Lord. The greatest travel danger any of us face is a loss of life. Once again, the Lord offers his travel protection. Look at verse 7. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. When you're looking around for help, don't look under the hills. Once again, the Lord is the way to go. God's people traveling in Bible times were tempted to seek help from the pagan gods whose temples and shrines were on top of the hills. They were on the hilltops. That's where they worshiped their pagan gods, the false gods. The Canaanite pagans looked for help from the false gods Baal and Asherah. You don't need to remember them. You just need to know they're false. These pagan gods promised help with the fertility of their family, their herds, and their fields. Their gods promised to make them rich and prosperous. They promised prosperity. They promised protection from the weather. The pagans looked to the hills for supernatural help. Many promises of help come to us in our day. The true believer cries, "Help, Lord," not "help anyone." We won't settle for any God. We won't settle for any help. We'll settle for help from God. The Christian knows his or her help comes from the Lord, not today's hilltop shrines. Our help comes from the living God who made the hills and the mountains. Help comes from the Creator, not creation. So let's brag a little bit about our God. His claims are true. God never sleeps. He never even nods off. God guards your beginnings and your endings, and the whole long journey in between. God well knows all the ins and outs of your life, and God promises to preserve you from all evil. All evil. Now, I know some of you wrestle with such a big claim. After all, didn't we say at the very beginning of this sermon that Christians suffer many of the same evils that afflict everyone else? We did say that. So what is the truth? What is the claim? We get more light for the journey in the New Testament. It's a progressive revelation from the beginning to the end of the Bible. In Romans 8:28, God's word promises that God will help. God will work all things together for the good of those who love him and according to his own purposes. This does not claim that no evil will happen. No evil will separate us from God, from his love, and from his purposes and his help. That's the claim. No evil will separate us from God's love, God's help, God's purposes, or from God. All the water in the ocean cannot sink a ship unless it gets inside. Likewise, all the evil in the world cannot harm us spiritually unless it gets inside us. To say that the Lord shall preserve you from all evil means evil will not destroy you. When evil comes and your faith is sorely tested, God will provide a way to escape from temptation. We keep trusting God, and we do not turn to the worldly help on every hill. So this is like the teaching of Jesus in the Lord's Prayer. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Most important of all, friends, God shall preserve your soul forevermore. That's what the psalm says. Our faith is not fragile or fearful. We do not fear losing everything in one moment. We are secure in the care of God. According to this psalm, 121, faith is an expedition, a long journey. And while we travel to the hills of heaven, we are blessed to experience God's help and protection from the beginning to the end, even forevermore.